Hello students, in present lecture I have discussed the topic hardenability and mainly about hardenability test. So first we have discussed about what is the difference between hardness and hardenability. So remember that hardness is nothing but an ability of material to resist penetration, and hardenability is the ability of material, that is the change in hardness at the every cross section of the material. It is also defined in another way, that is, it is the depth of hardness. That is the second definition used for hardenability. And third way it is defined with the help of hardness measuring scale. If obtain the hardness RC50, then we can say that is a hardenability. Hardness and hardenability have same unit, that is number, which is in either length or in mm. So hardenability of a metal or alloy is a function of mainly four factors, that is, first, carbon content of the steel, second, the alloy content in the steel, third, the grain size of the arsenide, and last is the quenching media. There are two methods used to determine the hardenability of steel. First is a Jomini and Quench test, and second, Grossmann's method. Commonly, Jomini and Quench test is used. So that figure shows the standard specimen used for Jomini and Quench test. This is a standard specimen with collar end and bottom end, which have standard dimensions in inches, and that dimension as per ASTM, that is American Society for Testing Metals, or SAE, that is Society of Automotive Engineers. And this is our Jomini and Quench test apertures. So first, this standard specimen is heated above arsenide temperature. Generally we have taken above 900 degrees Celsius temperature, and that heated in a furnace. After heating, that specimen is taken in this Jomini and Quench test aperture as shown in figure, and cooled with the help of water. That specimen is cooled from bottom end. So cooling rate is maximum at the bottom end and it is lower at the collar end. So hardness is also maximum at the bottom end as compared to collar end. So by using this hardness measurement, this hardness is checked after this cooling, or with the help of water, this hardness is checked with the help of either Rockwell, Wicker or Brinell hardness tester. And hardness of every cross section of this steel piece is checked, and then we get a graph of hardness versus distance from quench end, and that graph is called as a hardenability curve. This is the graph of hardenability curve. We showed at the x-axis, this is the distance from quench end, which is taken in inches, and hardness, which is taken in HRC. If we get a hardness 50 RC, and that graph is plotted with the help of this 50 RC, show the hardenability curve. So mainly, this experiment used to measure hardenability of material, and these four factors affecting that hardenability. First is the alloying element. If you use the alloying element, it increases the hardenability. Second factor, that is the grain size. Generally, arsenic grain size we have taken because we have prepared steel. So if fine grain size, then it reduces the hardenability due to a larger number of density of nucleation sites. Third, severity of quench. If you use the fast cooling with the help of water or brine water, then it gives a lower hardenability as compared to oil quenching, which increases hardenability as cooling rate is slow. And last factor, that is the carbon content in a steel. Generally, increase in percentage of carbon, it increases hardenability. If high percentage of carbon, it decreases hardenability. So remember all these things, and thank you. Thank you very much.